Serves as a common language, school instruction. is in English. Only about 500,000 Filipinos speak Spanish today. One of the three official languages of the country, the projected national language based on Tagalog and Spanish are also official languages. Tagalog is the language of several million Filipinos who live in the Manila area of Luzon. And there is a busy street in Manila. There's some buses and some horse carriages. And here we talk about the blending of East and West. American Filipino teamwork. World War II. The Philippines and the Filipinos. This says a scenic Bangsanjan Gorge is a visitor's must. I don't know if I pronounced that right. Probably not, but I'm trying. And there's a map. South China Sea, and you can see how dated this book is, but that doesn't mean that we're going to just throw it, the thoughts away, because there are still many, many people alive who remember these times, and we have to respect them to some degree. There is a native Filipino mountain tribesman, and he's very proud of his tattoos. This tells about the peoples of Luzon and their ethnic background. Malay. There's another very nice photograph. Look at that. Moro Datus, or chiefs, wear colorful costumes. Just too bad we don't have that. There's a carabao, water buffalo, and weaving. There's some more water buffalo, carabao, swimming. Wildlife. Pineapple cultivation. And the jeepneys, the brightly colored jeepneys. Juan de la Cruz, climate, topography, location, flora, fauna, racial origins of the people, and industrial development all are important in determining the makeup of a country, but in the final analysis, it is the people and the culture that they have developed that are really important features of a country. So, really, to know the Philippines, you must know its people, personified here by Juan de la Cruz. Juan de la Cruz is the John Smith of the Philippines, a very widespread and popular name, meaning John of the Cross, and indicating the Roman Catholic heritage of the majority of Filipinos. There's a nice house on stilts with a pig walking around underneath it. And there are people cooking pigs, planting rice, talking about family, weaving cloth, bamboo pottery. Religious fiestas. Not all that different from Spain and Italy. And here they're talking about different festivals, and here dancing with those big long bamboo poles. And about as valued. Superstitions and proverbs. You can hear the airplane outside. We've got another airplane passing. Popular sports. Championship tennis. National dances. Music. And the memorial in Manila honors the patriot Jose Rizal. The Philippines, past and present. Philippines became an independent nation on the 4th of July 1946. Voting. This is under Spanish rule. Ferdinand Magellan, a Portuguese navigator, while attempting to circumnavigate the globe with a small Spanish fleet, landed on Homon Island in Leyte Gulf on 16th of March, 1521. And it talks about him making the blood pact with the chief. The Americans come in World War II, and there's General MacArthur. Becomes independent. Schools are opened. Talking about the war years. The glorious war. And science and technology. Overseas is in Manila. Look at those rows and rows of graves from the Second World War. Naga City celebrates a fiesta on the water, almost like dragon boat racing. And now we have a big map, the Republic. Luzon, Mindoro, Palawan, Panay, Masrate, Samar, Leyte, Bohol, Cebu, Negros, and Mindanao. Sightseeing. Rice terraces, ancient rice terraces, astound modern engineers. Mount Mayon, the world's most perfect volcano cone. Hunting and fishing and shopping. Customers get dignified personal service. Dining out. Mestiza, Mabuhay is the Filipino's favorite and most used word. Like the Hawaiian aloha, it says welcome to a newcomer. And here's also have been leaks about driving in the Philippines, the monetary system, weights and measures, and suggested reading. It's quite a nice long bibliography there of suggested reading. And then we have a Tagalog language guide with lots of expressions, so like a phrase book. Sleep or feel relaxed. Wherever you are, whenever you are, always look at books. Always be good to yourself. Always be kind to others. And above all, always be extraordinary.